Howdy, howdy. I'm glad to be here. Hope you are too. I've been waiting for this. I'm excited about this, and I promise you I haven't forgotten, because some of you emailed me about I had promised a tutorial back behind the scenes funnel cake vendor that I got to see at the Boss Hog event a week ago, and just did the strawberry event and got to see tons of vendors, talk to vendors. It was an amazing thing. Something I want to tell you before we jump into why, and the reason we're here is to find out why one vendor out of six other people selling lemonade, why one had lines and the others had none. And when I say no line, they had no people. And you go, why? Why is it that way? And how does that happen? And how come this one vendor gets all the people and he's more expensive? So I'm going to go into that with you, but I want to share something with you about events. Okay, special to events, and I'll break this apart a little bit later, a little deeper dive, but if you're interested. But one of the things is I always teach vendors, you can vend with a pop-up table and some banners or some homemade signs. You're going to see all of that. I'm going to show you some vendors that did that, okay? And that's no problem, but you got to pick your place, okay? A place where is a one-year annual festival where people come from two states to get to it in the middle of the mountains, where the vendors are the creme de la creme, you're probably not going to do as well with a tiny little setup, okay? So that's just one thing, and it's not the thing that lost these vendors completely, but it's one of the things that added to their end success as far as not... there was too much competition for them. So I want to show how that all happened, what happened there. And I promise you, I will try to get the comments. I know I'm getting comments on this. Feel free to comment. I will go through them, but I may not be able to get to all of them, so don't get your feelings hurt or get upset with me. I'll do my best here. I want to share first a couple of these pictures with you, and if I can get this to work right, I think maybe, nope. So, I may not even be able to get my face up there, but I'm going to tell you what's going on here, and so that you can understand what's happened and what's going on with all these rows and stuff. And it's so crucial to know this stuff if you're going to go to an event. A lot of vendors go out of business because of an event they took on. That's their straw that broke the camel's back. I've seen good vendors lose their butts and barely get by from an event, because an event takes on a lot of risk. Okay. Ken Packer, who's pictured here in the center, the pink and yellow sign and swooper flag and the sandwich board and the pink wrappers around the booth. And I've got a video, I'm going to show you that. But he has done a phenomenal job in placement where he is in the arena of people. And he's done a great job in his setup. Okay, his prices are visible. Everything is easily seen. Plus, he's putting on a show. Okay, and even though Ken is typically pretty reserved, he's kind of an introvert. He's a dear friend of mine, but he is he's not loud like I am, and how I'd be, you know, I'd sound like a carny out there. The most I ever heard him say loud was, "Thanks, folks, for waiting in this long line," because there was people waiting for over 30 minutes because the line just kept building. And a lot of people were ordering multiples, and you'll see that in the video that I'm going to share with you. So that's one of the crucial things. So this big event, he's got all these people around him, and this is a line here in the center that starts basically where that person is in the peach shirt and goes all the way over, and that's two separate lines waiting to get up to his tent. Now I'm going to show you another one here. Let's see. Okay, so that's a little bit closer in. It's just Ken and one other guy running this whole show, okay? Could he have used about three more people? Absolutely. But he did this with two. him and another person. He did it with a helper, and it worked perfectly. It was flawless, and it just looks great. This is a more close-up view of his setup and the sign. You kind of see he shows the cards that they accept, Packers Lemonade, his logo, sugar or sugar-free. He's got it all for you. And so nobody's questioning. There's a guy in line, if you notice, in the gray shirt. He's already drank lemonade. He's coming in for a refill. He's wanting a refill. Okay, so he's already had one. He's paid $6 for that. Now he's coming in and gonna pay $4 more to get that bad boy refilled up. So a great deal. I'm gonna show you a few more of these, and I'll talk a little about them. Okay, so this is another one, and I'm gonna have to squeeze out of this one so you kind of see. This is another vendor, okay? And I caught them when I went around the second time. They had three people up there. It was a family, okay? And they were ordering lemonade, and it was the fancy cup with the cool lemon-shaped and colored topper. But I didn't never see any fresh lemons, okay? I looked around their booth. I never saw fresh lemons. They did have a slushy lemonade machine behind them there, but I never saw fresh lemons. Now, I could have missed it. They could have been behind the table where I couldn't see them, but nothing was out front. Like, you know, I teach in the course that to always have your lemons, like the fake ones or even a real basket of lemons on the table. They make some really real looking fake ones, but a basket of, you're going to have plenty there anyway. Take some of those old baskets and put them on your table. It really shows a lot. Ken Packer does that. Here's another view. This is of Ken Packer's, and there's more people in line. Now I'm going to scoot through these real quick for you and get down to the nitty gritty. There's one person up there in line at that lemonade stand. Here's one that this is a different angle on that same lemonade. You see there's slushy machines back there. And you see, I don't know if you can tell, but those yellow things on the table, those are their cups, their fancy little cups. You pay a lot more for those, but they don't represent you as well. You see the guy that I showed you earlier holding his cup, you can tell it's got strawberries and lemons in it. There's nothing says fresh like that. So this is another angle on Ken's setup, and just a beautiful setup. Long lines, people waiting to see. Okay, this is another one, Italian Ice, and they were doing lemonade as well. And nothing, nobody there, okay? And I don't wish this on anybody, but there's a value. I shared one little video clip, and it showed the one vendor to the other vendor, and it says, non-VU member, VU member. Ken Packer helps tons of people in our group. Because of the stuff he's willing to share and teach others about the vending business, and specifically about hot dogs and lemonade. He's got a hot dog cart and he's got lemonade, and does both a lot at this event. Is his biggest event he does, and he does the lemonade there, and he's the boss of it there. And people come from all over when he does lemonade because it's the best lemonade. Now, can you make it? Absolutely you can. He shares his recipe. It's not a big secret. It's just being consistent and using good fresh products, and then the atmosphere around it too. Here's another lemonade vendor, and I think they were doing snow cones as well. Do you see the lines around them? Me neither. This is the problem that a lot of people have. And here's one of the last videos. That's just a little closer up so you can see. And they're raising money for Relay for Life partially. So they were doing a little of both. Always love to see that. But it wasn't effective, okay? It wasn't effective for them. Now I'm going to show you a couple videos. You may have seen this video. It's a little bit loud. Hopefully you're taking notes, because there's little tips and tricks in this that will help you move on and become more successful, or start off without all the learning curves. I don't have it on the screen, and let me go ahead and tell you this. HowToStartALemonadeBusiness.com. Is a ton of free information on how to get started. I update it when I learn new stuff. There's a ton of information there. And you can literally start a lemonade business for under $300. So it's not a big expense comparatively of businesses to start. And you can start that business and make a killing, okay? We were just talking in the VU meeting the other night. I had a vendor last week quit doing hot dogs completely at the beginning of the year because his business with lemonade has grown so large. He can do it year round, and he's in the Midwest. Okay, so even when it's cold, he still does lemonade. Cost him more, okay, but he charges more. So let me play this video and pan over.
I'll get you in my cookies. Get
so at the beginning, at the beginning of that video, you saw the one I showed first, and then it's panned over to the others, and you kind of get a view of the whole event going on. The vendors that were doing the best out of all types of vendors, from funnel cakes to, were doing it out in the open, not in food trucks, okay? Something about being able to see what how they're making your food has a lot of credibility, and especially at an open-air market festival type of deal, you will do better from a cart than you would a food trailer. And I sell food trailers, but I'm telling you, you'll do better. Because there's a nostalgia to it. There was people whittling and selling, you know, art, all kinds of artwork and stuff. So they had tons of artists there, and they were sharing their art and selling their art. And so you're already in that frame of mind. You're coming for a good, wholesome family deal with tons of strawberries and lots of strawberry things. And now you can get strawberry lemonade, and you can get strawberry people. There's a lady doing frying. I say there's a lady. It's about seven people together in a little booth frying strawberry turnovers. So stuff that you could easily do. Funnel cakes with strawberries all over it. So there's all this stuff that you could do on a very small budget to get going. So the barrier of entry is small. And this is what he's found. Now, could he have made more if he had his hot dog cart and three more lemon stands? Yes, he would have made more. But he doesn't need to. And that's the beauty of it. You don't have to kill yourself to make a really, really good living. So that's one of the tips, is being out in the open where everybody can see you work. And I'm fixing to show you the next video, which you're going to get to see how Ken does it, what he does, how he talks and interacts with the customers. Hopefully you'll be able to hear it okay. It won't be as loud as that lady screaming behind me when I filmed that first one, but you'll be able to, you should be able to hear it. Let's go here, let's see. Bear with me. Well, see, I'm just walking around this crowd. You see people with buckets of strawberries. Three and a half quarts of strawberries for $18.
Lemonade's wonderful.
You hear that? Lemonade's wonderful beer. That's her second time there. And she just ordered three. So he splits them right in front of them. I mean, right in their face. And you see what she's doing? She's videoing. She's videoing. She's got her arm on the table videoing. Now, using the 090, which is one offer, that's something you can graduate into. That's about a $1,000 machine. You don't have to have it. You can have the hand press machines and do just the noise attracts people. Now, he squeezed all those lemons or pressed them into the bottom of the cup. He's using a clear 32-ounce deli cup. He almost filled that. See that? Now he's adding strawberries. Okay.
Special today while you're in line open.
More strawberries.
He's getting three for the price.
Yeah, there you go.
So this is simple syrup. Instead of adding the sugar and having to wait for it to dissolve, Ken has changed this over the last couple of years, and now he uses the simple syrup, which speeds it up and makes that in his commissary. So he's got a fresh batch of simple syrup. You'll see jugs of it behind him, huge jugs behind him there. You see how clean everything is? Brian just pointed that out. Brian just did a video for our members and Vendors United, and it is phenomenal. with his kettlebell.
Sale, won't risk it. Just leave.
I'll put an extra three sales on there.
Look at that. He's joking with him a little bit. And now watch, he just put the water in there, right on top of the simple syrup and the fruit. Now the lids are solid, there's no hole punched in it. And watch what he does. Shakes it up right in front of their eyes. They're getting to see those strawberries mush up and the water current turn kind of a pinkish yellow. And it's a neat process, and people are willing to wait for it. When done right, this is the way you do it. If you notice the top of his table, his pans are inset in it. He made those. He shares that stuff in our Vendors United group. It was just made out of a regular table. He just took it like a jigsaw and cut a hole to put his pans in here. But it looks professional. It's because he is professional. So now he's taking the money. This takes just a little bit. Now watch this. He'll loop it into a square. Now you can get a setup that's way quicker there on square. Once you get going, you can do one that has tap things out there in front of them, and they just tap the card and go. It's pretty easy. It tells you immediately.
Thank you so much. Appreciate you waiting.
So you see, he said, appreciate you waiting. Now, I don't know if you saw, I was talking, he punched holes in those. Look, she just ordered three more lemonade, she said. So that's pretty much the end of that. But I wanted to show you that what he did there is take this hole puncher, it's a straw hole puncher, and he punched holes in the lids of those three, handed them straws, and sent them on their way. Now, they'll walk around with that, and people will say, okay, and you will hear this walking around, people will go, where'd you get that lemonade? Where'd you get that? And they just point to wherever he is in the festival. It is a phenomenal way to do it. I don't think, Brian, that he has a speaker. It's loud there, and he would do well with a speaker of some sort. But I saw him yell loud like this. He yelled, and he said, hey, everybody, thank you for so much for being patient and waiting. I'll get to you as quick as I can. And people just stayed. I didn't even see people leave. And I stood there a long time. And check this out. I was there that close to him, and then I go around the other side, close to the other guy. Ken's back and forth. He even changed out his simple syrup jug. And they're big 5-gallon jugs of simple syrup. That tells you how much lemonade he went through. Okay? So you're only using a third of a cup of that per cup. So he's got jugs and jugs and jugs of that because he needed it for this event. So you're talking thousands of dollars. $6 a lemonade, you go through it, even 1,000 people, you're at $6,000. I would be willing to bet he did more than 1,000 people. So there was a gob of people here. It was supposed to rain. That's the other risk, is it could rain. And now you've got all this stuff, so you have to have a place to be able to save that stuff or get rid of it quickly over the next week while you're vending, normal vending. And so you always got to think these things through. Now, for some other tips on what I noticed the differences are that set Ken apart from the others. Okay, one is his location in the event. Ken has been to these before. Outskirts are never as good as inskirts inside the event. So the outskirt rows sometimes get missed because everybody kind of huddles up near the middles. Ken was the only one there. Ken used to would have never gone to an event where there was any other competition of the same type. If he was doing hot dogs, he wouldn't have accepted, and we teach that. Don't go to the event if there's going to be multiple hot dog vendors. Just move on until you get good at it, until you can afford a loss if you have to. And so what Ken does, doesn't care. He's honed in, knows where to vend. In that middle section's one of the key things. Do you see his setup? It really didn't cost any more other than the he's got 209 smashers there. But he, I'm sorry, I lost my train of thought. Somebody asked about the lemon smasher. I'll put the link in here maybe if I can think of it, and get you that. If Brian, if you're still listening, you could post it in maybe on the comments to the 09. I'd appreciate it. Hopefully I'm loud and clear. Let's see. Yeah. Somebody else asked about the smashers. Hopefully, I'm audible now. If somebody will tell me if they can hear me, I'd love that. Because I may have lost audio. I don't know. It seems like it's working. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? I'm waiting for somebody to comment and tell me they can hear me or not before I move on. Oh, thank you. Spicy Divorce Party Planner Show. I like that. Divorce Party Planner Show. That's kick butt. Never thought about that. What a great niche. Okay, thank you, Angie. Thank you, Alan. Appreciate you. Appreciate you. Kristen Nelson. Look at that. Kristen Nelson's in here. I've filmed her before. She is a phenomenal lemonade vendor. They do lots of money right in my town. They make a lot of money doing lemonade. And you can too, okay? And so one of the other things, a great setup, a superb setup is key. But this setup doesn't cost that much. I said except for the 09 machines. The rest of it, you could do for under $1,000. You could have a setup like Ken has. He's only recently added the 09s, maybe in the last year and a half, 2 years, okay, max. So he just added those. So that wasn't a part of it. And now he's got other equipment he has to haul with it for to have that. The hand machines is how he's been doing it for years. And guess what? He was still popular as heck and still the busiest one at this event every single year. And it's because of the way he does it. How clean he is. He's on an outside line. There's not another vendor next to him on one side. There is on this side, but it's not a food vendor. And then on the other side, so three of his sides has nobody around him. Well, guess what that means? People can walk up and see what he's doing. And so they feel safe. They feel like, oh my God, do you see how clean this is? If you stood there and watched him, he's constantly wiping down and doing stuff. The other thing is the clear cups. I already mentioned that, and I hoped you caught it. Clear cups are crucial. You can buy the fancy lemonade cups and hide your product, or you can do those clear cups. So when you put in strawberries and fresh lemons, people are going to go, where'd you get that? And that happens a lot at these things. So that's a few of the tips. Location, inside, setup, cleanliness, his cups, and then I want you to recognize his signs compared to the ones I showed you previously. Okay? Do you see how crisp and clean and nice and neat? And he puts a little, he doesn't need the sandwich board out there. You can see it there on the left of the screen. He doesn't need that there, but he has it there. He has it there because it's effective. It looks good. It shows professionalism. Everything is just looks top notch. You can do all this. You can learn all this. Go to howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. It's a long domain name, but it'll get you there. If you want a shortcut, hit learnhotdogs.com, type in lemon anywhere in the search bar, and it's going to pull up multiple articles, multiple videos, even videos that I just saw that Kristen was in here from my hometown. So you've got vendors that you can watch and learn and watch those videos and not start paying attention to the little details, because you're going to, the pro vendors like Kristen, the pro vendors like Ken Packer, you're going to be able to see what they do different, how neat and clean their operation is. If you notice Ken doing that whole thing is not walking around, did you notice that? That's something that Jason Brown taught to all of us years ago called the work triangle. How to just make one step to the right, one step to the left, but basically one foot is staying planted in the same spot all the time. And you're able to take credit cards, make the whole meal, and hand it to the customer. Talking to the customer, looking at them like Ken does, those are all helpful things as well. So those other vendors, I'm sure, made some money, okay? But if you're gonna go, why not be loaded for bear? Why not go and do it right? Why not do it to the best of your ability? Now, if you're starting out and you're going, Ben, I can't afford a setup like Ken Packer's, I get it. I started on peanuts, Spam, and Beanie Weenies and Ramen Noodles peanuts. So, but you can start the same way. You can start on peanuts. Just don't be at an event like this on peanuts, okay? You want to start slower. In fact, we teach, don't go to events when you're brand new. It's the easiest place for you to go out of business as at an event. There's a lot of inherent risk to events. And we teach about things you must know in events. If you type in the word event at learnhotdogs.com, we tell you everything to watch out for in an event. And it applies to any food vendor. But I saw food vendors there that were doing horrible, horrible. I saw a guy sitting down. That was another thing. Vendors sitting down. They're just sitting back waiting. Well, guess what people feel like walking up to you. They feel like they're bothering you, so they don't come up to you. Another thing Ken did, had his prices out front. You could see them. Everybody could see them. The other vendors were on their tables. Their prices were on the table, so you had to walk up there to see the price. Well, a lot of people, myself included, sometimes don't want to go up there because I don't want you to carny sell me or used car sell me while I'm trying to just read your dang prices and to see what your offerings are. So put your prices on the outside. Maybe put, hey, we do this or this. These people that put fresh squeezed lemonade and then don't, they ruin the business for others. The nice part about Ken is he puts it out in your face. That is his front counter. That's his front window. Right at the front door is Ken smashing lemons, and it works every time. So if you want to learn more and more and more and more, and I promise I will be back with the kettle corn. Not the kettle corn. I keep saying that. Funnel cake stuff. I'm also going to share kettle corn too. But anyway, the funnel cake secret that I learned, I had never seen in my life before, and I've been doing this a long time, and I've served funnel cakes. I had a funnel cake stand. I've done it, and I have filmed hundreds of vendors doing it, and I've never seen a cooler little setup than a guy in Georgia the other day. And I want to share that with you. And I even filmed, I started filming, and I said, hey, am I okay to film this? And he goes, absolutely, go ahead and share it. And I said, great. So I'd forgot to ask. Anyway, I love you. Thank you for being here. And I will see you, I'll see you next time. For all you VU members, we got a meeting tonight, tonight, 9 o'clock, be there sharp.